Very good morning, children. Today we are going to see about the revision program of November monthly test. Yes, revision. Revision is the good process because being well prepared for your exam is the best way to overcome the stress and the anxiety, and gives the best chance to getting more marks or grade, whatever it is. Today we are going to revise the topic, what are the questions may be expected for our November monthly test. First of all, in the fourth unit, the first questions may be asked, what do you mean by work, and what are the unit, how their dimensions can be calculated. Already we have discussed very elaborately, work is nothing but when we are applying of some amount of force on the body can be displaced the directions of applying force. It may be considered as work. For our definitions of physics, work is nothing but a force acting on your body which moves it by a displacement in some direction. It may be applying force along the directions can be move the body. And the equations can be represented as W equal to F vector dot dr vector. So we can simplify as the work done W equal to F dr cos theta. F means applying force, dr represents the body displaced, and theta be the angle between applied force and the displacement of the body. In some cases will be discussed, it may be work done is zero. Following cases, the first case is when the force is zero, there is no work done produces. The second case is when the displacement is zero, the dr becomes zero, there is no work done produces. And third case tells us when the force and the displacement are perpendicular to each other. In the case when the body moves on a horizontal direction, the gravitational force does not work on the body, so the work done must be zero. This is another work done in zero of the cases. And next move, work done by constant force and variable force. When a constant force F act on a body, a small work done dW by the force is producing in a small displacement dr. So we know the equations already, dW equal to FR cos theta, which means R represents as displacement of the body. So we find out the limit interval, which means the position displaced initial to final, so we can represent as Ri and Rf. So finally we get the equations of F cos theta Rf minus Ri. This is and work done by a constant force. In second topic, it may be asked work done by a variable force. The same process can be done in the process work done by a variable force. When the component of a variable force, here F represents variable force, act on a body, the small work done dW by the force is producing in a small displacement dr is given by. The same relation can be used in work done by a variable force. So we can write as dW equal to F cos theta into dr. Here F cos theta be the component of the variable force capital F. And next you are moving to energy. It may be asked in two more questions. Define energy. What is the unit of energy? What is the dimensions of energy? So energy is nothing but, it can be defined as the capacity to do work, or work done is the manifestations of energy. So any type of energy can be represented as in the unit of joule. So the unit of energy is joule. The dimensions of same as work, m l square t power minus 2. In our broader, the sense mechanical energy can be classified in two types, namely potential energy and kinetic energy. First, kinetic energy is nothing but the energy possessed by a body due to its motion is called as kinetic energy. And second one, potential energy. The potential energy is nothing but the energy possessed by a body by virtue of its motion is called as potential energy. This is the relation between kinetic energy and potential energy. Next, the most important topic of kinetic energy, and what are the relationship between work and kinetic energy? It may be asked to explain work kinetic energy theorem. This was the most important questions of 5 mark. So work kinetic energy theorem tells us the work done by the force on the body changes the kinetic energy of the body. This is called as work kinetic energy. Once again I repeat, the work done by a force on the body changes the kinetic energy of the body. So initially we get the two equations, work equal to Fs and force F equal to mv, and the relationship between the kinematic equations of third equations we know already, v squared equal to u squared plus 2as. From this equations we get the value of a, so a becomes v squared minus u squared by 2s. Substitute the value of e in the equations of f equal to ma, so we get the value of f, and substitute the f value in this equations of w from 4.7. so substitute the value of m, we get the equations w equal to m into v squared s by 2s and m u squared s by 2s. So simplify this equations, we get of mv squared minus of mu squared. Already we have discussed it, just revise the following content. So the change in velocity of final and initial, this is an work kinetic energy theorem. This expression can be tells us kinetic energy ke equal to of mv squared. So the relation is, finally we have conclude that w equal to change in kinetic energy. This is the work kinetic energy theorem. Questions will be maybe asked in 5 more questions. And next topic, correlation between momentum and kinetic energy. These questions will be asked me in our 2 mark or 3 mark questions, whatever it is. This is nothing but we know the equations of kinetic energy. So kinetic energy is of mv squared, dissipated the terms of v squared in v dot v, so separate to multiplying m by numerator and denominator. So we get the new equations and simplify the equations in terms of momentum. So we can change the terms of mv, we get the equations of p squared by 2m. This is the relationship between kinetic energy and momentum. And we can move potential energy. It may be asked in 2 more questions. What do you mean by potential energy? What are the unit of potential energy? And the 3 more questions can be calculated. Explain the potential energy near the surface of the earth by giving equations of u equal to mgh. It may be asked in 3 more questions. And finally, we are going to see conservative force and non-conservative force. conservative force and non-conservative force is nothing but this is to compare conservative and non-conservative. Conservative force is independent of path and non-conservative forces depends upon the path. In conservative force, the work done in a round trip is zero. Here non-conservative is not zero. Conservative forces, the total energy remains constant. Here non-conservative forces, the energy can be dissipated in the form of heat energy. In conservative forces, work done is completely recoverable. Non-conservative forces, the work done is not completely recoverable. In conservative forces, the force is the negative gradient of the potential energy. In non-conservative forces, no such relations exist. These are the relations between conservative and non-conservative forces. So all the best, my dear children, do well and keep reading more, tune out our distraction, focus on your studies, reward yourself and keep reading once again and revise the subject. Wish you all the very best. Thank you.